Here's Brody Brazil.
So you clicked on this video. I mean, you have a pretty good idea of what it's going to be about. So why is there so much tension I'm feeling already as I share that I have not ate meat in approximately 3 years? When I tell that to people in real life, it always comes with questions and commentary and surprise and shock and, yeah, a lot of times overreactions. It's almost as if I'm telling people I haven't been breathing air for the last 3 years. Or another analogy would be this: somebody who tells you they absolutely love the color orange. They could not live without the color orange. And if I say I don't like it, or I don't prefer it, or it's not for me, how can that be? That's crazy. I mean, it's pretty simple. I do it all the time. And actually, this is not my first time going without meat. I don't want to get too deep into the details or the backstory, but I was in middle school and a health or science teacher explained to us the process of literally processed meat and especially hot dogs, how they were made. And that turned me off to hot dogs and meat for approximately 2 years. I would probably say 6th and 7th grade or 7th and 8th grade, something like that. But anyway, I've been through this before. I went back to eating meat all my high school years, college, 20s, and obviously all the way into my late 30s. But here we are now, and it's true, I have not ate any meat in about 3 years. And I'll kind of share with you the process, but I want to make very clear here. I'm not trying to convince you into anything. I'm not trying to make a statement here. This is literally not about a platform to say something. I'm just sharing this because some people find it interesting. I'm more than willing to tell you about the experience, what I've found. I know that I am not in the majority here. I know that because if I go to a restaurant, which I don't as much lately, but if I do, I look around and see that everybody else is having a steak, having a hamburger, having a chicken dish, or, you know, something, fish, something like that. So I'm not selling you on what you should do here. This is not a convincing thing. This is more kind of me trying to answer a few questions and make a few points that maybe you didn't think about. Yeah, clarifying the process. Couldn't have said it better there on my presentation. That's what this is all about. So let me give you part of the process, and that is there was not just one reason for me, and also, by the way, my wife, to go plant-based about 3 years ago. Personally, I had never been a real adventurous eater. And by that, I mean, I never ate fish, never really liked it, just smell, texture. And chicken was something that I would order here and there, maybe to break up the red meat once in a while. But that is kind of the problem. I would always choose the protein as beef, like once or twice a day. I mean, usually not for breakfast, but for lunch and dinner. I'll tell you this, ham is not even something that I would have a lot. It was almost always red meat was my choice. And so one or two times a day, almost every day, that's a lot of red meat. And there have been obvious, you know, concerns about high volumes of intake. I'm not saying to cut it out entirely as I have, but there are, you know, some concerns with that. So there initially were some health benefits that I thought I might be able to capitalize on. But I also have to tell you here, I did not go into this decision intending to cut it out entirely. And by the way, my wife, part of this process as well, too. Both of us, all we were trying to do was cut back in 2018. And for a couple different reasons, time and planning of food and meals, and our son was still in his first year of life. I mean, there was a lot going on. And sometimes what to eat, what to cook, what to have for dinner or lunch, it's a complexity. And you'll understand that if you've been there. So it became easier for us to just say, well, cut meat out of our home diet. And if you go to a restaurant, hey, get the steak, get the hamburger, get whatever you want. But at home, we were just going to try and avoid it or cut back from it, just out of a bit of health reasons, but also simplicity. What happened was meat just became less appetizing. Like when I went back to a restaurant in 2018 or 2019, it became just kind of less appetizing. And I found out that I didn't miss it. And there was also, I'll never forget, an instance where after not eating meat for a couple months, One night there was, I was super hungry. I was at a function somewhere and there were some sliders, like mini hamburgers. And I thought, oh, I'm going to have one of those. I did. And my stomach just, I don't know if it was, they'd been out for a while or going back to meat or the amount of, you know, greasiness of the food, whatever it was. I'm not blaming anybody. And I'm also not saying that I'm incapable of eating it, but it just, it did not synchronize with my body that well. Just a pure stomach ache after that. So all these things, and I just found out, hey, it's just easier to take the fork in the road this way. Didn't mean for it to happen, but that is how it happened. And so this is ultimately what I want to get to. The heart of what I want to share here is the reality of eating a plant-based diet for me is this. One of the big questions from people is, well, yeah, how do you go to a restaurant? How do you eat out properly? And what do you eat, salads everywhere you go? That's usually, you know, something you hear from somebody who doesn't understand or get this. And there's been no problem, honestly, specifically here in California in the year 2021, there are always enticing options on a menu that don't have meat. And I credit, you know, the restaurants for having these options and coming up with something creative and not just throwing garbage out there as the only, you know, vegetarian option or plant-based option. So I have not had, literally in the last 3 years, anywhere I've gone. And that includes traveling, a little bit of vacation here and there, a couple spring training trips, Arizona, all over the map. Well, regionally, all over the map. Haven't made any long trips, but haven't had any problems ordering food without meat, stuff that I wanted anyway. Second point here out of these big four is that there are a lot of great substitutes. I'm going to mention the Beyond Meat product. Their sausages, their Beyond Meat sausages and hamburger patties, unbelievable. And I know they've branched out into like taco meat, stuff like that. Let me just say that everything they do can't be a home run in terms of texture and taste. But my goodness, start yourself off with their sausages and start yourself off with their hamburgers. Their products are unbelievable. And I've had enough people who eat meat try one of these and say, that is way different and way better than I expected. Because all you've known over all the years are bad imitation products. And yeah, it's just you take two bites and you're like, this is terrible. Like there are now great substitutes for meat products out there. And I realize some people are going to give me the criticism, well, doesn't mean you're eating healthy. Well, I know that. I just want to be able to, in the summertime, have the feel of eating a burger without eating an actual burger, if that makes sense. To some of you, that doesn't make any sense. But to me, weirdly enough, it does. And I'm just telling you, there are these great substitutes that you don't have to miss some of your favorite things now. There are products that can take their place. Another thing that people would say is, well, how do you gain or lose weight if you're not eating any meat, one way or the other? And it is important to still balance your diet, protein, what you're eating. Don't get me wrong. You can't cut out meat and say, I'm just going to eat pizza and pasta and peanut butter and jelly sandwiches all day. That does not work. There has to be a concerted effort into varying your diet, understanding what you're putting in still. You know, the absence of meat, you know, may make you healthier in certain ways, in some ways, but that doesn't mean that you can just throw other stuff in there and it's all good too. It's not. But I've certainly had no problem gaining weight, good weight and bad weight, while not eating meat. But I have, for me personally, not a doctor, have not found an issue with, you know, nutrition or not being able to gain or lose weight without the presence of meat. And the last thing I want to point out here is, people say, well, what's the biggest thing you have noticed then after not eating meat for now a couple years? And there's not, you know, quite honestly, there's not a lot of everyday things I notice. I don't think about this, quite honestly, on a daily basis. But the one thing I don't have as much anymore, and I did have it sometimes, especially after like a big piece of prime rib in the middle of that next night, heartburn, I don't have that. And I also don't have gut bombs. You know what I'm talking about? Where you just inhale some large meat product. You get the meat sweats. I have not had that in a long time. I've not had that since I stopped eating meat. Could just be me, my body, the way it reacts. But if I'm going to narrow it down into the one thing I notice, Yeah, do I feel a little bit healthier? Maybe. But that's probably the biggest thing that I tangibly actually notice. So there you go. Haven't been eating meat for 3 years. Some of you have probably been cursing at me this entire video. Why is this such a contentious thing? Like it shouldn't be that big a deal. And I hope as years and decades go on, it's not that big a deal anymore. Again, I'm not doing this for any other reason than preference alone. It's that simple.